So the key point to notice here, and this is why the one-time pad provides perfect secrecy, is that for any given ciphertext, we can produce any message we want by picking different keys. That means that if we just have the ciphertext, we haven't learned anything at all about the message. The way to produce the message BS from this ciphertext, well, we just need to change the first letter to be one below where C was. So that means we want to change this bit to be a zero instead of a one in the output. That means we need to flip one bit in the key. So we'll need to change this key bit to be a one instead of a zero. Everything else will be the same. This will change the output letter by one. So if we guess this key instead of the correct key, we get what looks like a fairly reasonable message out, but it would be one off from the one that was there. And in fact, we could get any possible message we want by guessing different keys. So this is what's called a one-time pad. And that notion of a one-time pad goes back until at least 1882. It was discovered quite recently that it was known about this early. There were one-time pads used in World War I and used in many other contexts since then. The notion of the one-time pad being known this early was only discovered last year by Stephen Belevin. What made a one-time pad really interesting was the analysis that Claude Shannon did. Claude Shannon was the father of information theory. He did some of the first theoretical work in cryptography. During World War II, he studied communication, and he also studied theory of secret systems. And he wrote this paper, which was the first paper that really understood in a theoretical way what it means for a cipher to be good. And this paper was written during World War II. It was classified and released in 1949. So what we're going to look at next is how you formally reason about a cipher being secure and why the one-time pad has all the security properties that make it a perfect cipher.